See it?
Here, look at the cat!
Look how creepy that cat is.
Oh, can I get my pumpkin spice latte? This is about our fifth time.
It's our second time! Hello, welcome to the weird start of YouTube. My name is Adeline Moore, and today I'm going to be showing you 50 travel life hacks.
That are stolen from the internet.
That I made up at least half of them. I made
you definitely
them.
Got stuck at 10. Girl?
Really quick, I wanted to say thank you to TELUS for sponsoring this video. TELUS is Ontario's largest mobile network, and they gave me an iPhone 7 to do this video. We're gonna be in Barrie, Toronto, and Brampton, Ontario, right?
That's a lot of places.
And TELUS has covered everywhere that I go.
Picking windows?
No, stop. You have donuts.
Oh, where are you? Where are you right now?
What?
The danger zone.
We're in Barrie right now. We're heading to the CN Tower. In order to get to the CN Tower, we have to go through Brampton. Let's do this. 50 travel hacks. Also, do you guys like this vlogging style? If you guys don't know, I have a vlog channel.
Idea. How will you keep the camera?
Matt always makes fun of me for keeping it not steady. But if you guys don't know, I have a vlogging channel and you guys should check it out because I'm doing Vlogmas. Link will be in the description. You can click somewhere at the end. I don't know, whatever.
Your viewers
want.
Probably get a concussion watching it here.
Stop! Number one. Just bring your carry-on suitcase. It makes everything so much faster and you don't have to check a luggage. And you don't have to pick it up at the carousel. Check in on your phone 24 hours before you actually fly. That way your boarding pass is actually on your phone and it's so easy. If you want to print it out, you can also ask them to print it out too. Place a dryer sheet in your suitcase to keep your clothes like smelling nice and fresh and reduces static. Make sure to roll your clothes instead of folding. It makes so much more room. Pill containers make good organizers, especially for jewelry like necklaces so they don't get jumbled up like a spaghetti mess. Also earphones. Put underwear and socks in your bra cups or like shoes to save space. You can buy travel size bottles at the dollar store and fill it with your actual shampoo and conditioner. That way you have the little teeny tiny bottle size. So you're allowed to bring big conditioner and lotions and stuff like that in your big suitcase. I feel like not a lot of people know that. Like they're always like, you need the little ones, but it's only for your carry-on. Wrap your shoes in a shower cap. That way your shoes that are always on the floor and dirty don't get your clothes that are nice and fresh and clean all dirty. Hotels usually have them. Get out of here. I stole this from Haley, but you can get earphones and put them around a binder clip. That way they don't get all like spaghetti mess all over the place. You know what I'm saying? Let's head over to Brampton.
All set, let's go.
Please. You.
Love you. Hey, guess what?
Guess what? Guess what?
Guess what?
You don't have a steady hand. Should we search up on Google on our TELUS Mobile, Ontario's best new mobile network? Search the CN Tower.
On that phone?
Yeah, on this
phone. Are you serious right now?
Serious. Yep. What are the stars?
3.5.
That's it? Out of 5?
Look at the view. People don't go there for the food, they go for the view.
Right. Why is the view dancing? You're so funny.
Because I don't dance.
Nearest gas station.
Okay, here's what I found.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, okay. Adeline decided to pull in the sketchiest gas station in all of...
It was the nearest one.
In all of the ice bucket we call Canada. Literally, she got scared of driving, so she's making me switch.
I'm gonna call CN Tower and tell them we're gonna be a little bit late. We have a reservation under Matthew Barrie, 6:15. Would that work? Bye-bye. You're so nice. You can use Google Maps offline by typing OK Google and the visible area will say for future access. Instead of throwing away a water bottle at the security, you know how you like can't bring water? Empty it, bring the bottle and fill it back up at your gate. That way you don't waste, reduce, reuse, recycle, and you save $4. This one's kind of sneaky. When reserving seats with someone on a plane, reserve the window and the aisle seat so that there's an empty one in the middle. Usually people won't pick one that's in the middle, so you'll have the whole row to yourself. If not, when it's in the middle, you can just ask to switch seats. If you forgot your little like box charger thingy and you only have the cord, usually at the back of the TV, you can like find a USB port and you can charge it there. Number 15, if that tip doesn't work, then you can ask the front desk for a charger. I'm sure that they have a gazillion and people always forget it. Front desk usually has everything, so that includes like chargers, toothbrush, toothpaste, shower cap, but don't rely on them having it. If you have data on your Ontario's largest mobile network, you can check to see if the hotel has Wi-Fi by searching up like reviews and stuff. Hotel Wi-Fi is usually free in the lobby. Bring a power strip. Do you guys know what that is? It's so amazing. If you want to charge your computer, charge your phone, charge your camera, charge your everything. On the last day of your trip to a foreign country, you can grab all of your change and give it to the homeless. If I'm not doing too well, I'd be so hard on myself. Here it is. We're here. have a feeling you'll like it. Are you ready for this? My other boyfriend.
Then you can wear my sweatshirt.
We made it.
We're almost an hour late for our reservation.
I know, but we told them we were gonna be late. Look how cute Tiffany is.
Yeah, she's all dirty because you never
clean. No, she has her little reindeer antler. She's so pretty. Instead of booking a hotel, book a house. Sometimes the prices are cheaper too. Get traveler points and fly for free. Book your flights way in advance. One time I tried to book a flight from Toronto to LA and it went from like $300 to $1,000 the next day. It was so crazy. Hotels can be cheaper in advance too. Depends, like if they have a lot of room, it'll be a little bit cheaper. But if they don't, it's like a hit or miss, you know what I'm saying? Number 25, make sure to call your credit or debit company before you leave. Because they might think it's like suspicious activity and like completely cut off your credit card and you won't be able to spend money and you will be very screwed. When you mark your bags as fragile, then they put it on top of all the other luggages and they also don't throw it around. And it's usually one of the first ones to be on the carousel. Find a phone plan. You could use Best Mobile Network in Ontario. TELUS, which is what I have. We just passed by Brampton and Barrie. Now we're in Toronto. Bring comfy clothes and wear a jacket because planes are so cold. If you have layers and you can just take it off. Airlines think I want to like make frosty snowman up in the sky. Like no, I always bring napkins and tissues and stuff like that because I feel like my nose is always running on flights. Noise canceling headphones are a lifesaver, but sometimes it can be kind of annoying because they make you take it off like when you land and when you take off. So you can have earbuds too. Download movies on your phone. Sometimes they don't have movies built into the seats and my dad said he always gets nauseous on planes except when they have movies. If you get nauseous really easily, download movies on your phone. Matt's waiting, we're all waiting in line to go up to see a tower. But we have number 31, wait, I have one. Buy a portable phone charger. It's like the biggest lifesaver ever. It's usually a mission to find an outlet on a train, on a car, on an airplane, or if you can, get a rechargeable backpack. It has like a solar power thing. If you want to remember where you're parked in the city, where you need to meet someone, or where you, if you need to remember a hotel, drop a pin on Google Maps or take a picture of your parking space. Use the share my location on your iPhone or for Uber, share your ETA. This allows your mom, your dad, or anyone to know where you are at all times with your phone on.
We have elevator music, so in the elevator.
Just to let you know, the speeding elevator at the moment is 22 kilometers per hour, which means 50 miles per hour. And we will be in the restaurant in around 6 to 1 seconds.
You like the view? View's okay, right? It's like meh. First up here?
Oh yeah.
Their service?
Oh yeah. You should have the best service in the world.
Can I have a phone for a sec?
There's a magma.
Alright. If you're traveling with something breakable like a mug, then you can wrap it around in a floaty or even like a sweater.
Bubble wrap?
Who has bubble wrap lying around? Or a towel. If you're going to a beach or somewhere watery, then put your phone in a plastic bag. That way it's waterproof. Use a pot holder to store your flat irons even when it's hot. When it's hot. The restaurant's so fancy, I like don't fit in here. Use binder clips to make sure that your razors don't like hurt someone, I don't know. Take a picture of your passport. There's so many times where I had a scare and I thought that I lost my passport. I was like, oh my God, I'm gonna be in the US forever. Like there's no way I can get back home. So always have at least a digital copy on your phone just in case. To prevent bottles like perfumes and stuff like that from leaking, make sure to wrap it in a Ziploc bag or at least put like plastic wrap or saran wrap over top of them. It's like glowing. We'll search your flight number and it will usually tell you your gate, if it's delayed or anything, that will update you. If you want to carry a cold lunch, frozen sponges and plastic bags, they're security approved alternative to ice packs. Do we have straws?
We don't have straws.
Flip necklaces through a straw to make sure that they don't get all tangled. Don't pay for hotel water. If tap isn't clear enough for you, then you can go to the gym, the hotel gym, and they usually have water over there. Save that money. Get that water that you can steal. Some airports are good for connecting flights and some are not at all. So always make sure to search. And when making connecting flights, always make sure you have at least an hour. Ask for a free room upgrade. Even if they say no, it's worth a shot. Write your phone number on a kid's hand that you're traveling with, a person that you're traveling with, because like nowadays, who actually remembers phone numbers? Thank you.
I don't want to read the video.
That way if you accidentally get split up and like your phone dies, you can get get in contact with your person. Learn to use AirDrop and Wi-Fi. Those are so, so, so nice. Some cameras have built-in Wi-Fi. Like, once you take your photo on your camera, you can, like, use Wi-Fi to put it straight onto your phone, you know? That way you can share on Instagram in the moment with Ontario's largest mobile network. Your phone charges 3 times faster when you put it on airplane mode. Mm-hmm. Number 50, ask to see a selection of rooms when you check in. Hotels usually unload the worst rooms first, so you gotta pick the good ones. Bonus! If you're only traveling with 2 or less people, make sure to go on Uber Pool. Sometimes, I'm not talking about all the time, but sometimes nobody else picks up, so you literally get to travel for half the price. If your clothes get all wrinkly in your suitcase, hang them up in the shower, and then when you take a hot shower, the steam will unwrinkle them. Or can use the flat iron for your hair for ironing your clothes. I did this one time with Matt. You remember one time when there was like a little sliver of light in between the curtains? So I grabbed a clothes hanger with the little clamps on it and then clamp it together. That's how you get rid of that annoying sliver of light. Like, just want the darkness. I'm all done with the video. Wait, I need to do the outro. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure to give it a like and also make sure to subscribe and become a member of the Arrow Angels. Make sure to check out my social media. It'll be down below with Adeline Morin for all of them. Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, all that stuff. Thank you so much to Telus for helping me make this video and having amazing service and always, always having my back. We were in Brampton, Barrie, Toronto, and it worked all throughout the time. Also, comment down below if you guys like these like vlog style videos. It's my first time ever doing this on my main channel, and make sure to check out my vlog channel. By the time that I post, I'm gonna be doing Vlogmas. That's one vlog every single day of December. Holla! I hope you guys have a beautiful, magical, wonderful day. My tip today is to not film at a fancy restaurant because everyone will be like, what the hell? Matt hates this thing. The glass. He just like hates heights and Imagine Dragons. All right, you're relaxed. Sit down with me.